Thank you, Vermont! You know, it's a funny thing. 31 years ago today, we won the mayoral race in Burlington, Vermont. And we won that race against all of the odds. Everybody said it couldn't be done. And when we began this race for the presidency, everybody said it couldn't be done. But tonight, I tell you with absolute confidence, we are going to win the Democratic nomination. And we are going to defeat the most dangerous president in the history of this country. We are going to win. We are going to defeat Trump because we are putting together an unprecedented grassroots, multi-generational, multiracial movement. It is a movement which speaks to the working families of this country who are sick and tired of working longer hours for low wages and seeing all new income and wealth going to the top 1%. It is a movement which says the United States will have health care for all as a human right. It is a movement that says we will bring major reforms in education, making sure that all of our kids can go to college without coming out in debt. Now, what makes this movement unique is we are taking on the corporate establishment. We are taking on the greed of Wall Street, the greed of the drug companies who charge us the highest prices in the world, the greed of the insurance companies, and given the existential crisis of climate change, we are saying to the fossil fuel industry, we are saying to the fossil fuel industry, their short-term profits are not more important than the future of our country and the world. But we are not only taking on the corporate establishment, we're taking on the political establishment. But we're going to win because the people understand it is our campaign, our movement, which is best positioned to defeat Trump. You cannot beat Trump with the same old kind of politics. What we need is a new politics that brings working class people into our political movement, which brings young people into our political movement, and which in November will create the highest voter turnout in American political history. So we're going to beat Trump because this will become a contrast in ideas. One of us in this race led the opposition to the war in Iraq. You're looking at him. Another candidate voted for the war in Iraq. One of us has spent his entire life fighting against cuts in Social Security, wanting to expand Social Security. Another candidate has been on the floor of the Senate calling for cuts to Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, and veterans programs. One of us led the opposition to disastrous trade agreements, which cost us millions of good-paying jobs. And that's me. And another candidate voted for disastrous trade agreements. One of us stood up for consumers and said we will not support a disastrous bankruptcy bill. And another candidate represented the credit card companies and voted for that disastrous bill. So here we are. We have two major goals in front of us, and they are directly related. First, we must beat a president who apparently has never read the Constitution of the United States. A president who thinks we should be an autocracy, not a democracy. But second of all, we need a movement and are developing a movement of Black, white, Latino, Native American, Asian American, gay and straight. Of people who are making it clear every day they will not tolerate the grotesque level of income and wealth inequality we are experiencing. We will not give tax breaks to billionaires when 500,000 Americans sleep out on the streets. We will not allow 49% of all new income to go to the 1% when half of our people are living paycheck to paycheck. Now, I don't know what's going to happen later tonight. We're doing well in Texas right now. We won Colorado. And I'm cautiously optimistic that later in the evening, we can win the largest state in this country, the state of California. But no matter what happens, if this campaign, and I don't know what will happen, but if it comes out to be a campaign in which we have one candidate who is standing up for the working class and the middle class, we're going to win that election. And if we have another candidate who has received contributions from at least 60 billionaires, we're going to win that election. And if there is another candidate in the race who is spending hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars, we're going to tell him, in America, you cannot buy elections. So I am excited about where we are. We have come a long, long way. And I want to once again thank the great state of Vermont and all of the people in the state. Not only for the victory you gave our movement tonight, but for the years and years of love and support you have given me and my family. So Vermont, Vermont, from the bottom of our hearts, thank you all very much. Let's go on to the White House. Thank you.